वेलकम एवरीवन, आई पीयूष पटेल वेलकम यू ऑन टुडेज डिस्कशन ऑफ टेलीकॉम सर्विस दैट इज भारती एयरटेल। फ्रेंड्स, भारती एयरटेल बिलोंग टू टेलीकॉम सर्विस इंडस्ट्री। सो हाउ इज टेलीकॉम इंडस्ट्री? वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे सम डिटेल्स ऑफ टेलीकॉम इंडस्ट्री। वी विल नो विच कंपनीज करंटली आर देयर इन टेलीकॉम इंडस्ट्री एंड whether this industry is growing or not, and if it is growing, we should invest or not, if invest, at what level and how much money. So it would be an interesting session. Before we begin this session, let me announce two important events. Number one event is on 1st November. Yes, again, for the fifth year in the row, we are going to meet with the Mumbai investors for a 3-hour five step toward wealth session. Since last 4 years, we have met every year, and our purpose of this 3-hour meeting is to discuss some growing industries and top quality companies and some strategies. So I welcome again all Mumbaian investors along with Pune. So for Pune, this is the second time we have arranged this meeting. So it would be a wonderful discussion. This meeting would be in Marathi, Hindi and English language. Apart from this 3-hour five step toward wealth meeting, from 8th November onward, a new batch would be started, who would be learning for next 11 weeks fundamentals and technicals of stock market, especially for wealth creation. Register yourself if you have 20 minutes daily. We need to invest 20 minutes a day for next 11 weeks if we want to learn everything practically. If we want to learn which economies are going to grow, which industries are going to grow, which companies could outperform other companies, at what level to buy, what should be our target, and what should we expect from stock market. At least, let us avoid wealth destroyer and only focus on wealth creators, right? So this was about event. Let us get back to our topic. So what is the topic? Telecom services. Yeah, India is currently the second largest telecommunication market and has the third highest number of internet users in the world. India's telecom subscriber base expanded at a CAGR of 19%, reaching 119 crore during financial year 7-17. So we can say, yeah, that in India, people with telephone connection are more than total population of US, right? But yeah, paying capacity of US is two more than Indians. And that is the reason, despite low population, their companies are having high turnover. We will see this all things later. Tele density means it is defined as number of telephone connection for every 100 individual. In India, has increased from 18% in 2008 to today 93%. Right, we can say that in 2007, there were only 18% out of 100 people using telephone, mobile. Today, 93% means, yes, now we are good penetrated. So India surpassed the US to become the second largest market in the terms of a number of apps download. Dekho to mobile khol ke kitne app download kiya aapne? Just think about it. We have just surpassed US, and today we are number two in the terms of app download. So just think about it. Every company has target that Indians should download their app. Hum kisi ke target pe hai? Kyun? Because they know that Indians' income is going to rise in coming 10 years and they are going to purchase several things online, right? Now, Indian industry witnessed another last year of hyper competition as well as high regulatory headwinds. Due to high competition, in spite of an increase in subscriber base, the majority of the companies have shown degrowth since the last decade and are in huge losses with huge debts. That is the reason majority of the companies have destroyed the wealth of investors during last decade. Post COVID, this industry is in high demand again, and ARPU is increased first time after a long time. Uptick for the whole industry is seen, and this could be the sector to focus as the demanding sector after a long time. Yes, telecom could be high growth sector for coming decade. So now, if telecom could be a good sector to invest, and we have already discussed that they are in high debt burden, let us see which companies are there and where to invest. So as we can see, as proper telecom, there are seven listed companies, majority making losses, negative debt paying capacity, negative ROE, sales growth muted since last decade, and majority have destroyed wealth. Bharti Airtel, Idea, Arcom, MTNL, TTML, and some others. Yes, here there is no Jio. Why Jio is not listed? And Jio actually is in a digital telecom. So till now, Jio is not listed here, but in coming time, we will see that Jio sales would be also calculated, because Jio may be digital, but today, due to Jio, all other companies are suffering their sales, because majority of the client base from other telecom have transferred to Jio. In fact, as you can see, if we do not count Jio, these all companies combinedly do turnover of around 1.4 lakh crore. So 1.4 lakh crore turnover, but they do losses of around 1 lakh crore. That is a huge thing, right? Investment, stakeholder investment in all of these companies is around 36,000 crore. Just think about it. 36,000 crore invested by stakeholder. Still, they are making loss of around 1 lakh crore. So that is the reason many companies have made huge losses for investors. You can see here. Now, Bharti, apart from Bharti, all other companies are making losses since a long time. Right? You can. Bharti is the single company which have made loss just last year during last 17 years. So we can say Bharti is the only company which is highly consistent. Majority of the companies have made profit only 1 or 2 years during last 17 years versus Bharti only to make loss single year. Right? We can see on low equity, they are able to do high turnover versus you can see Idea. Equity is 29,000 crore and they are doing just turnover of 44,000 crore. Why not Bharti, which has equity of just 3,000 crore, but sales of around 90,000 crore. So if we are selecting the company, we should select those company for investment who need lesser money and can do more business. We can see here that Bharti is with less money and they are doing high business. So should definitely focus on Bharti. See, we have given the data of debt also. You can see that Bharti is having debt of around 1 lakh crore, but yeah, we can say on this 1 lakh crore of debt, they are able to do turnover of 1 lakh crore. Not good, but not bad comparing to other companies. You can see even Idea is having more equity. That is, we would be having more partners. So per share income would be very negligible. And debt also, they are having even more than Bharti. How is this possible? But yeah, it is possible. See, you can see which is smart company. Bharti with 1 lakh crore debt doing turnover of 1 lakh crore. Idea with 1 lakh crore debt doing turnover of only 45,000 crore. Avoid this type of companies and only focus on good ones. If this sector is going to show U-turn, company like Bharti can create good wealth. But avoid this Idea, Arcom, MTNL, TTML and all these companies. See, let me clear. If sector will be performing good, you will see all the companies would be performing good. But some companies will need another 5 years to come to profit. Versus company like Bharti can turn profit first year itself. That is this year. Right? So, my suggestion would be focus only on Bharti Airtel. right? And considering that, do not invest more than 1%. Let us see, as company will improve their sales and profit, debt should be decreasing in coming time. Airtel, currently its price is 433. See, during Q1 also we have seen huge growth. That is the reason we have recommended to buy near 394. And see, price was around 550. Many people were saying, Piyush bhai, 550 chal raha hai, 400 kaise aa sakta hai? Koi explanation? See, market is highly volatile. We should always be prepared for it. Aisa mat bolo, ye kabhi tootega nahi. Logon ko kya hota hai? Jo achha lagta hai, unko lagta hai kabhi nahi tootega. Jo bura hota hai, unko lagta hai kabhi nahi chalega. Arre, dono taraf ka movement hota hai, dosto. Right? So be prepared. Aur Bharti jaisi company jahan pe depth zyada hai, to prepare rehna chahiye. Volatility to zyada hi rahegi. Right? Now, current year, current H1 ka result aa gaya. Bharti's price is 433. As per yesterday's price, sales have grown by 16% and losses have fallen by 38%. Right? Company Bharti Airtel is a leading global telecommunication company with operation in 18 countries across Asia and Africa. You can see that Bharti do turnover in several different countries. See, 22% turnover come from India mobile business. 50% turnover come from India mobile, 25% turnover come from Africa, 13% from Airtel business, 6% from tower business, 2 from home service and 3 from digital TV. Right? Company ranks amongst the top 3 mobile service provider globally in terms of subscribers. In India, the company's product offering include 2G, 3G, 4G. Abhi 2G, 3G bhul jayenge. पर देखो अभी भी रूरल में हर जगह तो होगा नहीं 4G, राइट? मोबाइल कॉमर्स, फिक्स्ड लाइन सर्विस, हाई स्पीड ब्रॉडबैंड, डीटीएच, एंटरप्राइज सर्विसेज इंक्लूडिंग नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस सर्विस टू कैरियर्स, इवन दे हैव टाई अप इट विद Amazon फॉर द क्लाउड बिजनेस. सो यस, इन इंडिया क्लाउड बिजनेस वुड बी डन बाय बोथ एयरटेल एंड Amazon. And that is again a growing industry of tomorrow. So they have over 42 crore customers. 24 years back, they have started their operations and have taken huge benefit of the telecom boom in India. They reached the sales of 96,000 crore. That is around 1 lakh crore during 2016 and profits of 13,000 crore. See, as you can see here, during 2002, their turnover was just 1500 crore. As telecom boom was there, why telecom boom we can say? Because there was a time when we have to stand in line for this BSNL connection, right? Now, we saw private participation 20 years back, and that is the reason today everyone is having a mobile and a telephone. You can see how Bharti got benefit. They just started, as we discussed, 2 decades back. In 2002, their turnover was 1500 crore and just they reached 98,000 crore turnover in 2015 and they were going to touch 1 lakh crore landmark. See, in India, there were only few companies in 2015 to reach 1 lakh crore turnover. Even HDFC Bank was not doing this turnover in 2015. Maybe TCS was nearby to this turnover. For few companies, but they were not able to reach this landmark. And today we can see during 5 years, there was a degrowth due to too high competition, right? The turnover fell from 98 to today, just 88,000 crore, right? But it's all right. We can see huge boom. So considering current data, we can see that 25% CAGR, their sales have grown during last 18 years. During past five years, if we see, it was actually degrowth of 2 years, right? Due to this thing, see, our cost was increasing, interest was increasing since long time. So what happened? The company, which was in consistently profit, we saw during last 10 years, company was not able to grow its profit. Why? Because they were not able to grow their sales during last 5 years. So what happened? Last year, company posted loss for first time after 17 years, right? But yes, that was good thing that their reserve were in continue increase. Why? Because we can say that profits were not increasing, but at least they were able to do profits. So this was a company with positive cash flow versus all the others like Ideas and Tata, TTMLs and Arcom. Every company were having negative cash flow. You can see that in fact, let me show you reserve of this Idea. See, this is the reserve of Idea in my raw data. They are having negative reserve of around 23,000 crore. What a bad thing. And in fact, Bharti with positive reserve, right? So we can say, yeah, that due to this thing, should only focus on Bharti and not in the companies like Idea. 1 lakh was invested during the IPO till 2016. The valuation, can you see? 2 crore. So during this 14 years, 1 lakh was converted to 2 crore. The company has this potential in growth. Why? Because we saw their sales was growing, profits were growing. Right? ऐसे कंपनियां मल्टीबैगर नहीं होती है, ये वो ही कंपनी है जो कितना दिख रहा है आपको, सिर्फ 500 करोड़ का प्रॉफिट करती थी. इन 2016 प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम 500 करोड़ हैव कन्वर्टेड टू 7000 करोड़, राइट, ऑलमोस्ट 15x. एंड दैट वाज द रीजन दिस कंपनी क्रिएटेड ह्यूज वेल्थ. नाउ सिंस 2007 ग्लोबल रिसेशन, ह्यूज कॉम्पिटिशन वॉज सीन इन इंडियन मार्केट, which made the growth slow and profits down, right? You saw that just 5% growth was there. Sorry, minus 2% sales growth was there. And in fact, cost have increased by 26%. During the past 3 years, sales were in continuous negative growth and company were in profits were loss making. Many companies were out of business during these 5 years. Bharti was one of the strongest competitor in the Indian market. We have been recommending to add some quantity in the range of 275 to 200. Let me show you chart of Bharti. This is the chart of Bharti. Can you see? This was the huge rally and just during last long time, this company was in correction mode. So no problem if we add it at this lower level. See, this is the lower channel. We need to accumulate every time during 250. So we have been recommending to add during this range. Many people hold for a long time, but the stock was in long range bound mode in the range of 550 to 200 for last 13 years. So 13 saal se nahi chalta tha. 250 से बाउंस होके 500 तक जाता था. सो इट वॉज अ लिमिटेड रेंज. वाई? बिकॉज देर वॉज नो ग्रोथ इन प्रॉफिट, देर वॉज नो ग्रोथ इन सेल्स ऑल्सो. इन फैक्ट नाउ अलर्ट हो जाओ, सेल्स हैव स्टार्टेड ग्रोइंग बाय 20%. तो तैयारी रखो, प्रॉफिट तो बढ़ने ही वाला है, राइट? सो लेट अस डिस्कस ऑफ करंट स्टेज. सी, कनेक्टिविटी हैज बिकम इवन मोर एसेंशियल अक्रॉस ऑल रियल्स ऑफ लाइफ, work, education or entertainment. The Q1 this year saw healthy revenue growth of 15% and the growth has sustained even in H1, as sales during H1 have grown by 16%. Yaar, sabke dhande gire hue abhi to, dhande sabke down aate ja rahe hai na, par ye samay pe Bharti ke dhande badhte ja rahe. Kyun? Dekho, aapke bacche bhi abhi mobile pe honge education mein, hum bhi mobile pe hai. So all have converted to data, right? So grown by 16%, which shows huge demand, with mobile business growing at 22%. This was driven by two factors: sustained momentum of 4G customer data of over 15 crore, coupled with improved tariffs. देखो भाव भी बढ़ाए हैं. Every company have increased their prices. Customer base of at 44 crore. इन 16 कंट्रीज, बढ़िया कस्टमर बेस है. अब देखो, जियो ने तो इतना कस्टमर बेस पहले ही साल बढ़ा दिया है, राइट? पर भारती का भी 44 करोड़ बुरा नहीं है, पर जियो तो कंपेयर ही नहीं कर सकते यार. पहले साल आके तुमने क्या धमाका किया, यही बेस तुमने बना दिया. वंडरफुल जियो, और इसी का फायदा रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज को मिल रहा है. लॉन्ग टाइम ग्रोथ इज सीन इन टेलीकॉम ड्यू टू हाई डेटा यूसेज along with new customer addition. H1 sales have grown by 16% and have continued to witness strong data traffic growth of 74% year on year. एवरेज ए आर पी यू जो खाली 128 था, देखो वो भी बढ़ के 162 हो गया, यानी लोग ज्यादा खर्चा कर रहे टेलीकॉम की ओर, राइट? भाव बढ़े तो भी अभी लोगों को पता नहीं चला है. इन सच अ केस वी मे अगेन सी लाइफ टाइम हाई सेल्स ऑफ लैंडमार्क 1 लाख करोड़ दिस ईयर इटसेल्फ. देखो मैं तो आशा करके बैठा हूं, देखो कैसे मैं बता दूं आपको. दिस इज H1 सेल्स ग्रोथ. 16% सेल्स ग्रोथ इज देयर इन H1. If we consider this year, Aarti growing by 16%, then see this year itself we would see 1 lakh crore turnover. तो मैं आशा करके बैठा हूँ, वो चीज जो 2016 में रह गई थी, 15 में रह गई थी, this year we are going to see Bharti lifetime high sales of 1 lakh crore. Yes, high lifetime high profit will not be there, but 2 साल में हम लाइफ टाइम हाई प्रॉफिट भी देखेंगे. ये जो 6,000 करोड़ का, 7,000 करोड़ का प्रॉफिट था इस साल तो नहीं, पर अगले साल जरूर हम 8,000 करोड़ के प्रॉफिट तो पहुंच सकते हैं, राइट? ये साल कम से कम लॉस से प्रॉफिट में हम लोग आ जाएंगे. आई एक्सपेक्ट भारती टू रिच अराउंड 12,000 to 15,000 करोड़ प्रॉफिट टिल 2030, और धंधा 3 लाख करोड़ पहुंच जाना चाहिए भारती का. आने वाला समय बूमिंग रहना चाहिए भारती का, तो वेल्थ क्रिएट हो सकती है. लेटर फोकस इधर बाय करने का, 50 MEMA इज वेरी गुड प्राइस टू बाय, यानी 394 के करीब मिलता है, वी नीड टू बाय, एंड एटलीस्ट वी कैन हैव 560 टारगेट दिस ईयर. कैसे देखते हैं जरा, वी हैव शोन ह्यूज लॉस ऑफ 30,000 करोड़ लास्ट ईयर, बट दिस H1 वी सॉ मार्जिन्स इंप्रूविंग बाय 38%. यू कैन सी हियर बड़े ना, 38% से मार्जिन इंप्रूव बढ़े हुए है इस साल, राइट? दिस ईयर वी मे सी भारती टर्न टू प्रॉफिट ऑफ 4,000 करोड़ अगेन. ड्यूरिंग द पास्ट 17 ईयर्स, लास्ट ईयर वॉज द सिंगल लॉस मेकिंग ईयर फॉर भारती. पिछला साल एक डब्बा था भारती पे, काला दाग लग गया भारती पे लॉस करके, लेकिन भारती ने ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट किया है. तो मेजर किस चीज का खर्चा है, देखो आप देख सकते हो इधर कॉस्ट डेप्रिशिएशन का लग रहा है, तो दिस इज नॉट रियल लॉस, राइट? एज यू कैन सी 15,000 करोड़ वॉज जस्ट ड्यू टू डेप्रिशिएशन, सो वी कैन से दिस वॉज नॉट रियल लॉस, राइट? अगर डेप्रिशिएशन हटा दे, यस वी कैन सी भारती इन प्रॉफिट अगेन, ऑल राइट? सो ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ अराउंड 1 lakh crore हैज बीन डन इन कैपेक्स. Up-moving subscriber base along with sales and huge usage of data can be inflection point for telecom companies. New buying can be done during any fall near 400-394. बोला ना 400 ध्यान में रखने का. We may see price move toward 560 this year, right? And 757 in next 2 to 3 years should be our target. Buying, considering huge debt of 1 lakh crore, buying should be done with limited quantity and weighted should not be more than 1%. यार 1% से ज्यादा नहीं खरीदने का. धीमे धीमे देखो कैसा comfortable लगता है. We can increase our weightage, right friends? So this was all about Bharti and telecom sector. Yes, Bharti और Jio की जबरदस्त टक्कर देखेंगे. देखते हैं 5G इंडिया को कौन पहले देता है. Jio is a new story for India. कोई डाउट नहीं है, आज जियो का जबरदस्त फायदा रिलायंस इंडस्ट्री को मिल रहा है, और भारती और जियो एक बढ़िया कंपनी है टेलीकॉम में से, राइट? दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट टेलीकॉम. थैंक यू सो मच एंड बेस्ट ऑफ लक टू एवरीबडी. कमेंट इफ यू थिंक No, some other company is better than Bharti in this telecom. Or you can comment whether if you think that this industry is not good. Achha laga ho program, you can share it and subscribe it so that aur koi industry miss nahi ho jaye. Jai Hind.